Megan start.
Clap. Ready, go. A couple of things before I introduce our illustrious guest speaker. First of all, I'd like to thank Ray and Mark, who did the buggy parking at the Carrolls. Lime Tree Productions, who did the event for Malphus, came to us and said, can you find a couple of people to park buggies? Mark and Ray put up their hands and they said, I will give you a donation. I thought, oh, might give us 50 bucks, might give us 100 if we're lucky. And a check in the mail for $250 from Lime Tree for parking. How many buggies do you reckon you parked, Ray?
About 6.
Yeah, so, well, very good return rate. So I'm going to put a hand up for buggy parking no matter when and where. So that'll be good. Number two, fourth Sunday of the month coming up this Sunday. So it'll be barbecue down at Domain, and we're also going to do one on Boxing Day because that tends to be a fairly good day, so I'll be looking for some volunteers pardon me for both of those days. So just come and see us and I'll work out, we know when and we know where, we just work out a time. Just at the Boxing Day one, we do tend to start a bit earlier to hopefully get those who are lining up and can't wait to spend their money when the shop opens at 10 o'clock in the morning. I'll introduce our...
I've changed the format.
So. Yes, that's right. We're going to ask our guest speaker to dance on early. I'm here to introduce Clint. Now, Clint's got two attributes. One that he's almost the youngest member in the club.
Better check with
Amy. B, he's a good AFL fan, and I suppose the third one is that he's doing some good charity work. So I'll get... Clint to come up and tell us what we're on about.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Just wait till Jimmy sparks up a new battery for us in his pointer. So this morning, pretty well going to go through the Horizons program with the Gold Coast Suns. Over the last sort of month, we have been speaking more with both the Gold Coast Suns and our district. There's been a committee formed, and I'm fortunate enough to be chair of that committee. So there's a Gold Coast Suns Rotary District 9640 committee. On that committee, we've got past district governor, Graham Jones, the current foundation chair, Neil Jones from Broadbeach, myself, the incoming public relations, Harold's position? Yeah, incoming public relations for the district, Harold Bush. So we've been having some meetings along with Sandy and the Gold Coast Suns with what we can do coming into next year. And Jimmy's killing me. Once I get this pointer, I'll show you more.
Oh,
look. Okay, so everyone knows that we were doing the raffles out at the Gold Coast Suns this year, and we did build on a relationship with the Suns and their board. There's quite a few Rotary clubs within the district that did participate in that event, and Rotary raised about $6,000. There's about $6,000 of money raised that went towards Rotary, and will be distributed early in the new year. That money, there was no cost to Rotary. It was only participation at the events. All prizes were offered by the Suns. And pretty well Rotarians just had to go along and sell the tickets each game. We not only raised some money there, but we also raised awareness within the community, and that's what that program really shed some light on. It's helping us as our district to improve our public image and strengthening our brand awareness and allowing people in the general public to be aware of what we do as Rotarians. So to rewind a little bit back, we recapped at the end of the year, and I sat down with Graham Jones at Sanctuary Cove here, and we had a meeting and looked at what we did with the raffles and where potentially we could take this program moving forward with the Suns. He started to show me where Rotary International are looking to go and what are the things that he thought that we needed to do in our district to not only prosper in this little area, but to prosper as a whole as Rotary. And so I started to have a look at the global outlook and what Rotary's internationally is asking us to do. I don't know whether any of you guys have actually read this document, but it's a pretty impressive document. It's all about where we should be at and where Rotary International wants us, or what things they want us to do with regards to our public image. If you have a look on across the top here, all things like print advertising, radio, TV, outdoor advertising, internet marketing, press releases, publicity, presentations and special events. These are all things that Rotary International want us to do to help get the message out there. I guess that in today, we know things are tough in charitable organisations, so we really do need to start fighting for our piece of that pie. It's getting harder and harder to raise funds and to highlight or get recognition for the good things that we do. And Rotary does amazing things when you look across. I don't need to preach to you guys on what we do, but are people aware of what we do, and are they seeing that there is a lot of value for money within our organisation? I don't think so. So if you read through this doc, I'm not going to read through it here, but there's quite a few interesting things. The Rotary National Director actually talks about the importance of controlling our public image, and the only way we can do that is if we actually start branding and looking at what we're doing. He talks about it's important that we're at the forefront of outlining where we want to go, what we want to do, and things like that. And if you have a look around globally, what other districts are doing at the moment, there are some pretty impressive things that are happening with branding, especially with polio, on billboards, with associations, with larger groups, corporate groups and stuff like that right across the world. Graham and I were talking about what can we do in our district to make that better. At the moment, this is the type of stuff that I found that we were doing, lots of print, media, newspaper, stuff like that. Are these types of media going to put us in good stead? Is that going to be ahead of the group moving forward? I don't think so. I think not only is this type of media very expensive, it really doesn't touch too many people in our district. It's something that has probably worked well in the past, but I think if we're going to be serious and really looking at branding ourselves and helping strengthen our brand by increasing public awareness, potentially increasing our memberships, and potentially increasing the amount of money that people actually give to us through different alliances, we need to do a bit better than this. This is another one. I mean, I don't think I've used my DVD player for the last 2 years, but we still do DVDs and stuff like that. These things will be things of the past, and we really have to move with the times. So getting on to the opportunity that we have with Horizons program, I'll start to talk you through. They actually invited us along about 2 months ago into the Suns and presented to us an opportunity. I was fortunate enough to have Sandy come along and Graham and all of our committee to see what the Suns had in mind for our partnership moving forward. And surprisingly enough, it sort of hit a lot of things on the head for us. So we know what the Gold Coast Suns are sort of doing. Corey's come out and spoke. They do a lot of community stuff, and they really presented to us Rotary in a great light. They've had a really good experience with all the clubs out there, and we're really impressed with how we've been with their supporters.